be here simply because this was a task that was performed by the late Dr. C.S. Ramachandran for many, many, many years. And stepping into those very large shoes is not the easiest of things. I try to do it every time I get this opportunity. So let me first thank all of Rotary Club of Madras South, specifically Madhu, for this opportunity. President Srikant, Secretary Rajan Babu, fellow Rotarians, very specifically Tamil, was president during my year, and his spouse. The two of them are always special. Every governor looks at his president and first lady as a very special set of people. Compared to so many Rotary themes that have been given, this particular theme is simply a statement of a fact. I was trying to find something witty to start with. But then what do you say witty about Rotary Connects the World? He didn't say Rotary Connects the World. No, he said Rotary Connects the World. It's a statement. Statement of a fact. How factual is this statement? All of us know in our own different ways. But let me start with a little story. It was soon after the International Assembly, that's where governors elect are trained, and that happened at San Diego, and I think it was the last day of the International Assembly. People were generally tired by then, and there were people who were sauntering in for breakfast, and I think my wife and I, we were one of the earliest who landed for breakfast that morning. I picked up my breakfast and I looked around. Most of the tables were empty. My wife had already picked up her breakfast and she was sitting in some other desk, some other table. And then I saw a gentleman sitting in one table and probably he was having his coffee and finished his breakfast. I went and sat there at the table and we greeted each other. And we knew we had to be fellow governors because only governors were allowed. And we exchanged pleasantries, and from his English, I knew that English was a foreign language to him, but he spoke English well, and I also knew that from his accent, he was German. We started talking for a little while, and then suddenly, our conversation became serious. He was a serious person, he was talking about serious aspects, with very many aspects about Rotary. And we found that we were discussing and we were discussing very well. We discussed for about 10, 15, 20 minutes and by the time the crowd came in, we exchanged cards and that marked the end of it. One of the things I need to tell you about the International Assembly is, while it is a place where everyone goes for training, all the governors go for training, this groupism still remains. You know, the Indians remain with the Indians and the Japanese with the Japanese and everybody. Much as we try and say that it is one place and all those things, that is there. So, even during discussion sessions, you don't get to meet somebody whom you totally don't know. It's the same group that kind of, they try to mix it up, but then there's a limitation to all that. So, I had met this gentleman and then, soon after I came back to India, he contacted me. Dr. Peter Kibla. Any of you who have been watching what's going on in the Rotary News and the Rotarian, you would have realized Dr. Peter Kibla was an RI director for 2 years, starting 2 years ago when Bhaskar was there. Peter Himmler became an extremely close friend of mine, of ours I must say, visited Chennai, and when he was governor, based on the various conversations that I have had with him and things like that, he called me to Germany for his conference as a speaker. I was still a governor at that time and I went there as a speaker to his conference, District 1880. But that's not all. Just a few days ago, maybe about a week, 10 days ago, we are launching a huge dialysis project catalyzed by BDN Muthupadiyamman or district governor elect Muthupadiyamman and the contacts of district 1818, which is the partner district in the club there. And the project is a global grant project, which is probably going to have something like 18 or 20 dialysis beds in Royapuram or Kaliyarpet in one of the facilities. Somebody whom I didn't know at all, somebody whom I just met by chance and became friends with over a period of time, resulted in a very large project which is going to benefit a huge amount of people in the northern Chennai area. I believe President Mark Maloney said, Rotary connects the world. This is what he meant. He meant that you met people whom you would probably never meet. You end up meeting people and through them you end up doing good things in the world which is going to benefit a whole lot of people. There are multiple other examples, a lot of them which many of you may know, and one of which is something that your own club did. Was it during your Silver Jubilee year, Madhu, when you invited all the Silver Jubilee clubs, families to come here?
Golden
Jubilee. Golden Jubilee. 50th year. I still remember the function held in one of the circular hall where I had come and attended. And I believe that that particular exercise gave a tremendous amount of impetus for so many good things to happen in RCM South. And I am extremely glad to know that this year, this Diamond Jubilee year, you are planning something very similar, trying to get the same batch clubs visiting you. There cannot be anything more exciting than that. It may be called as an international service project. But then, the fact of the matter is, it's an international service project per se, which will probably result in a plethora of community service projects carried out over a period of time. And therefore, it is the sheer definition of world understanding. And I do believe that if you do this, it's not only fellowship, it's not only friendship, it's also world understanding, it's also international service, it also results in community service. So let me wish you this year all the very best for this project. There was another gentleman, I think it was, his first name was Irving, but his second name was Stone. Irving Stone, I think. Irving Stone is also an author, if I remember right, but then his name was also Irving Stone. A youngish looking guy who walked into one of our meetings, my club meetings, or a joint meeting. Then I ended up talking to him and he said that he was a student of the Ayurveda College in the, in Poonamali, run by the Kamakoti Pitam, that trust. And he said he is a scholar, Rotary scholar, and that's the reason why he has come here for this meeting. Meeting was over, we said hello to each other, etc., etc. That marked the end of it. Then it so happened that I had gone to one of the project sites in Nagpur. And I was taking the train from Nagpur to come to Chennai. And then who do I see in that compartment? Mr. Stone seriously buying sandras, buying oranges from in Nagpur during that summer or whatever the weather. I just went and he couldn't place me immediately, but then I went and jogged his memory and he said, oh yes I do. And then we had all the way from Nagpur to Chennai to interact, which he did. And soon after, he went and set up practice in Portland, Oregon. He continued to remain in touch with me. He became a Rotarian in Portland, Oregon. And he was instrumental in doing some excellent projects, not with our district, but with some other district. But that's exactly what happened when you connected to the Rotarian. I had put him across to somebody and that's the way it happened. Rotary connects the world. This is not through a Rotarian, but somebody else, through an ambassadorial scholar. Friends, you know, when you go to the discussion session in the assembly, lot of topics are spoken about. There is a plenary on a subject, and then you are broken into discussion groups, and then you go 24-30 of you go to a discussion group, and then you start talking about it. What was spoken in the plenary, that's the discussion. And polio usually is the topic, and in the discussion session that I was in after polio, there was a mix of people. There were a lot of people from the United States, and there were a lot of people from India, because the language has to be common, so they don't put in people who don't speak English. So they make sure that people who speak English are put together in a room. I could sense, while the discussion was going on polio in 2008, polio was supposed to be banished, but it recurred. There was polio in India, not yet banished at that time, and of course we had Pakistan, Afghanistan, all those things. I could see that there were quite a few people who were actually very angry. Why is it that we need to keep continuing to give to polio when polio has actually been removed from all of the Western Hemisphere, and then India continuously keeps getting money? A little undercurrent was there. But then there was this one lady who came up in the discussion session and said, I believe that unless and until we make sure that every child is safe, no child is safe in this world. And it does not matter, as Rotarians, we need to give to polio irrespective of where polio is existent at this point in time. I don't know why, but it really tugged at my heartstrings, because here were people who didn't have to give to polio. They were giving year after year after year after year to eradicate a disease which was not prevalent and not at all anywhere near prevalent in their own country or their own community. They don't know who's wearing the drop. They don't know where that money is going, which mouth is getting the drop, but they give it simply because they believe in the Rotary adage that Rotary reaches beyond borders. Friends, I believe Mark Maloney said, Rotary connects the world is simply because first we as Rotarians, we make sure that we stay connected. Here, I would like to make a slight deviation. Somehow or the other, I get the feeling, this is a very personal feeling of mine, that there is a changing face of Rotary right now. Rotary is changing. Sometimes it is changing beyond recognition. Recognition of mine maybe, but maybe it is probably the way Rotary has adapted to every change. But what is happening, I believe, is that we are trying to give up some of the best practices which were internationally acceptable and trying to put in a little bit more of the local traditions inside. Right or wrong, I don't know. But the moment we start getting more and more localized, I believe we will be less and less connected. The more and more adaptive we are, we will be more and more connected. So this is the flip side of what I see that is going on in terms of what's happening in Rotary, where we are becoming a little too localized. Sometimes we are even becoming militantly localized, I would say that. Then militant localism, I would believe, needs to be given up. And I think we need to start opening ourselves a little more and accepting a lot more of inputs, just to make sure that we remain the broad-based organization that we always have been. And that, I believe, is the flip side to it. Each one of us, several times, I'm sure would have received telephone calls from all corners of at least our country, asking for help, and usually it's medical help. Many times I have received calls from people in North India saying that XYZ has been admitted in CMC Vellore. Will you be in a position to see whether some help can be given? Somebody can go there and find out what is the exact nature. That's again connecting the world. Again, I have found some absolutely unconnected set of people giving me a call saying that XYZ is the head of this organization Recently, I got a call. I'm not going to name anybody. I got a call from somebody in Bangalore saying that there somebody was admitted in one of the hospitals here, got treated, went back, got an allergy due to medicines that was given, went back to the hospital. Hospital dismissed it as no problem, it's not our problem. You have to get admitted, treated. Again, a few more lakhs of bill was slapped on them, and then they decided to wake up and see how best it can be organized. And concerned, a very senior person in the hospital was a Rotarian, whom I knew. I could reach out to that person, and you won't believe it. The patient, the family, gave me a call back saying that, thank you sir, we got complete free treatment. Absolutely nothing, no, nothing was done. We have to use our contacts to connect. First, I would believe we need to stay connected. Second, we need to make the connections, new ones. Third, we need to use the connections for all the good reasons. So my friends, Mark Maloney, I believe, wanted to re-establish the fact that Rotarians, Rotary should stay connected not just amongst themselves, but first with the community that it was living in, because that's max that we can go. Rarely you will get an opportunity where you will be able to cut across boundaries and connect as you are going to get this year. But this is an opportunity, and I believe that Rotary Club of Madras South must write about this project and send it to none other than the Rotary International President, saying that we connected across X number of countries or X number of continents to be in touch with so many number of Rotarians and establish the fact that Rotary connects people. So, let me wish Rotary Club of Madras South a wonderful Diamond Jubilee year. Stay connected. Make sure that the connections are true and legal. Thank you.
The first question from me, sir.
No, I have to ask you a question. Yeah. I have been told,
from my speech, I have to ask a question. Can you repeat, can anybody recall the name of the Rotary International Director, my friend, who has helped us do this dialysis project?
Peter Bugler?
Okay, I mean, I'll give it to you because Peter is correct. You have just let Peter explain. It's Peter Imbula. IBH Elia. Peter Imbula.